Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com and upphone.com, and in this video we are going to explain what to do when your iPhone XS, XS Max, or XR won't turn off.
Now this isn't the worst problem to have in the world because your iPhone is working, but you gotta know how to shut it off. So the first thing we just want to mention is that a lot of people might be new to the iPhone XS, XS Max, XR, and the process has changed for how to turn off the iPhone.
You used to be able to just press and hold the power button, yep, slide to power off. However, iPhone X, XS, XR, XS Max, it's the side button and either volume button. Press and hold those together, slide to power off, swipe the icon left to right.
Yep.
iPhone turns off.
Mm-hmm. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to eliminate the possibility of a software problem. Mm-hmm. Because software is always involved, even if it seems like it might be the hardware in your phone, because the software is what says, okay, iPhone, let's turn off now.
Yep.
So we're gonna check the settings app to see if we can use just the software, not the buttons, to power off your iPhone.
So we'll go to settings, we will tap general, and we'll scroll all the way down to shutdown. Tap shutdown. When you do again, slide to power off will appear. Swipe the icon left to right. If you can shut down your iPhone with the settings app, but not the buttons, there may be a hardware issue with the buttons where your buttons just aren't working properly, they're not responding properly.
Right, and if that's the case, you might be wondering, how do I turn my iPhone back on if the buttons are broken? All you need to do is plug it into power, and then it will turn on automatically.
Right.
So the next thing we're gonna do is, let's assume it's a software problem with your iPhone, and this is probably the most common reason why iPhones won't turn off nowadays. It's really not the buttons that break as often, especially in newer phones. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna hard reset your iPhone.
Yep.
And it used to be different, this has all changed as well.
Yeah, iPhone XS, XR, and XS Max. Press and release the volume up button, press and release the volume down button, press and hold the side button until the Apple logo appears. Do you wanna do that for me?
Sure, I'll do it. Yep, it's very quick. So volume up, volume down, side. And just don't let go of the side button until the Apple logo appears on the screen, mm-hmm, as David said.
There we go. Can take 20, 25, maybe even 30 seconds for this to happen.
Yep.
So just be patient, keep holding, don't give up.
Mm-hmm. Especially if you have a software problem.
Yeah.
All right, Apple logo appears, I can let go and the phone will reboot.
So let's assume, yep, you know, next step, iOS update.
Right, which is sort of the extension of the software troubleshooting, right, process. A lot of the time, an iOS update will fix problems, mm-hmm, with software, and this could be one of them.
So we'll open the settings app again, scroll down and tab general. Tab software update. It does look like I have a software update available. I'll download and install that later. Mm-hmm. Just tap that button. iOS update will download. It'll install. You need at least 50% battery life to do, yep, an update, so yep, just be aware
yep
of that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's how you have to update your iPhone.
Right, so next step is to DFU restore your iPhone. This is the last software troubleshooting step that we have, and a DFU restore takes everything off your iPhone first, so make sure you have a backup, and then puts it all back on your iPhone again. And if there is a software problem that's causing your iPhone not to be able to turn off, this is gonna fix that problem.
Yep, so we have a great video walking you through that entire process. There's a link below in the description and above in a card. If the DFU restore doesn't work, there's probably a hardware problem, mm-hmm, with your iPhone. First step, Apple Store, especially if you have Apple Care Plus. There are also some great third-party repair services that mail in, come to you. Great services, we'll link to those below in the description and above in the card.
So that is what to do if your iPhone won't turn off. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed, please subscribe to our channel. Make sure to click the notifications bell,
yep,
to get immediate updates whenever we upload a new video.
Sure.
There are some other things I have to say. Upphone.com is the best place to compare cell phones online. So,
yep,
if it won't turn off and you're like, I need a new phone because it won't turn off, because that's,
yep,
a great reason to get a new phone. Check out upphone.com. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for the,
yeah,
best
you already
iPhone
said that,
tips on YouTube.
Double check.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for watching.
There's a lot of things to say.